When you think about modifying cars, you typically think about stuff like wrenches and shiny metal objects, swearing at them a lot until they work. At Cobb, we do plenty of that, but we spend even more time with keyboards and looking at code on a computer screen, swearing at that until it works.
Try to remember some of the basics of CQC.
If you took computer science class in high school, you know that the term ROM stands for read-only memory. The term's actually discussed quite a bit behind the scenes when developing tuning support for modern cars, but the context is a little bit different. The ECU in your car is a computer. It has a processor and memory, and just like your laptop is run by an operating system, the engine in your car is run by a program that's stored on the ECU's ROM. The very core of OEM ECU tuning hinges on the ability to expose and modify the data in the ROM. Accessing, adjusting, then rewriting the original OEM ROM is what allows a tuner to make changes to things like timing, fueling, boost, and so on. The thing that gets a little confusing is that ROM is a literal component on the ECU, but we also often refer to the program on the ROM as a ROM. Each OEM uses a specific ECU for each generation of a certain car, but even within a single generation, there can be many different versions of the program that serve as the ECU's operating system. Each of those different versions are referred to as different ROMs, so providing full tuning support for a generation of even one car model usually requires the discovery and modification of many different ROMs that exist in different forms across the world, and tend to change every year. Sometimes even multiple versions exist within a single market. Thanks, California. Then to take it even further, in order to make the cars perform special functions that the OEM never designed into the car from the factory, like flex fuel, advanced launch control, map switching, etc., we even make customized Cobb versions of the ROMs with unique tables that can only be applied with an access port and our own custom software. This is a huge topic if you really want to dig into it, but at the very least, hopefully that gives you a basic understanding of what we're referring to when we use the term ROM, and the amount of brain power and effort that goes into making it all work so easily for you.